One key consideration when designing a machine learning system is whether we do training in a static way, offline, or dynamic way in a continuously updating online fashion. Now, when we say static offline training, what we mean is that we essentially have a big store of data and we train our model exactly once before it's used for a long period of time. When we talk about dynamic online training, we mean that data is continually coming into our system and we're incorporating that data into the model through small updates. These both have different strengths and weaknesses. Now, for a static model that's trained offline, there are some definite pluses. It's easy to build and test. We can just use batch quota. It's nice and cheap. And we can iterate on that model until we know it's good, it's nicely verified, and we can make sure that everything is working well before we ship it off to serving. The downside here is that it still requires monitoring at the input level at inference time. If our distribution of inputs changes and our model hasn't adapted, well, we may end up with screwy predictions. You know, in a similar vein, it's easier for this model to grow stale. You might imagine if a model is trained on pre-iPhone data and suddenly the iPhone comes out, there's no good way for us to get that information into the model without accounting for some kind of retraining. A dynamic model that's trained in a continuously updating fashion, of course, has much more sort of heavy weight in terms of monitoring. We need to have more system complexity and larger monitoring capabilities in order to make sure that this thing isn't going off the rails. The plus side for all this extra work is that we have a model that's able to adapt over time as new data comes in, and so we don't have this staleness issue. So a good place to use offline training is when we don't think that our data is going to change very much over time. An example for this might be a large image recognition model, where there just aren't that many new kinds of objects that come into the world. A model that's trained online might be more appropriate for situations where, in fact, there are trends and seasonalities that change quite often over time, and we want to make sure that we're as up-to-date as possible.